Today is the first day of the rest of your life, and your future planning started yesterday. You need simple, easy strategies to create maximum results. This is The Scotty Show. Time to get your ducks in a row with Scott Leonardi, owner and president of Complete Solutions, Inc. As a certified financial fiduciary with 25 years in the planning industry, Scott helps educate you on how you can make the best decisions for your family and your finances, and helps you get your ducks in a row for your incredible future. Let's get started.
Hello and welcome to The Scotty Show with Scott Leonardi. Scott, what's going on, man?
Hey, all kinds of wonderful things. How are you doing, man?
I'm doing fantastic.
Spring is in the air.
It's getting warmer. There's people getting vaccinated. We're not going to get into that or politics today. We're going to be able to go outside more often now.
Yeah, that's exciting. That's exciting. Get out there and mix with some people.
Yeah. And speaking of mixing with people, this podcast is all about mixing and meeting with people. For those that are just joining us, the first podcast we did was Scott's inaugural podcast, and that kind of gives you a little bit about his history, gives a little bit about him personally, so you kind of get to know him. You definitely want to go back and listen to that one. But this podcast, if you're interested in engaging Scott or curious about what it looks like to engage Scott and his team, you're in the right place. This podcast is all about what does it look like to just call you up. So I'm going to pose that question to you right off the bat, Scott. This podcast is nationwide. You're going to have a large audience listening to this. As they listen to it and they learn something and they come back and they say, hey, you know what? I do want to meet with him. I do want to call him up. What does it look like to work with you from beginning until I'm a client or just finding out what that path looks like? So somebody listens to the podcast and they call you up. What's the first thing that happens?
Well, that's a great question, Eric, and I'm glad you asked that question because I think a lot of people out there today would love to have some advice, some direction, mm-hmm. some help, but they just don't know who to call, and they're uncomfortable on who to call because, let's face it, in today's society, a lot of people out there are trying to pitch their wares, per se, right? They're trying to sell you something, and they're not trying to help you. And I do numerous educational workshops, and the first thing I ask people, I said, hey, has you ever been to a seminar where the second you walked in, you felt like you were being sold? Of course, every single hand goes up in the air, and I say, listen, that's not what's going to happen here, right? And maybe some other guys say that, but listen, that's not what's going to happen here. My job is to educate you. I'm a huge believer in education. I just think education makes the difference in everything. Mm-hmm. Everything. And just because you learn about something doesn't mean you have to implement it, right? But you have to learn and become knowledgeable. I really think there's three important facts about Complete Solutions, my company and myself. Three important facts. Number one, we're not like everybody else. And we truly are not. You know, we use a holistic planning process, to look at your whole entire retirement program as a whole. Because guess what? We have to address all those areas that could possibly hurt you and affect you in the future. My grandma used to always say, hey, listen, Scott, don't worry, because what you don't know won't hurt you. Mm. Well, who thinks that's a load of crap, right? What you don't know is pretty good chance it's going to hurt you, right? Yeah. Some of those areas, if they're neglected, they can really hurt you in the long run. And the second thing is we want to make things easy for people. Easy. My goodness gracious. Life is so complicated at times. It's so confusing. And with complication, that creates avoidance. Mm. And with any type of planning, avoidance is death, right? Yeah. I mean, so we can't create the avoidance. Easy, Eric, easy gets things done. So we want to make it easy for people. And lastly, we truly do want to help people. We provide tons of education, lots of different tools for people to become educated. That's all at no cost. We don't charge people for that. We do a variety of different free reports that can help people avoid costly mistakes. Now, some companies charge people for every report or every tool, and I just don't believe in that. My philosophy is if we can help educate somebody and we bring them closer to deciding that they should change a little something, maybe if they've liked us so far, we've helped them so far, we've earned the possibility of doing some business with them. And so I think that makes a big difference. I think that's completely different than a lot of companies out there.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, that sounds fantastic. So I'm listening to this. I said, I like that. I like that attitude. I like that approach. So I pick up the phone and I call. What happens?
Well, I tell you what, I'm incredibly blessed. I have a wonderful, wonderful handpicked team. I really have. And again, I can't say I handpicked these people and everything was perfect. It was a lot of luck in finding the best people, right? I got a staff that's just incredible. They care about people. They want to help people. From the first person that answers the phone and takes the call, trying to find out, hey, how can we help you? How can we help you? What are you looking for? Exactly what the process is. And sometimes it's just a matter of sending the client out something or sending the, the prospect per se out something. Just to kind of read and review. We do a lot of referring people back to our website. I think it's so crucial to learn a little bit more about somebody you could possibly deal with. Mm-hmm. So we're always pushing people back to our website, which is duckduckplan.com. Helps you understand who we are and kind of what we're all about.
Scott, I would assume that a lot of times, obviously, the team that's answering the phone, they're going to ask those questions that you just spoke about. You said that you're going to possibly send out some information. I know that this podcast is part of your educational endeavor to reach and teach other people all across the nation. I'm assuming they could probably refer them to some of the podcasts that would fit the scenario. So if I'm calling in saying, I want to make sure I don't run out of money in retirement, I want to make sure I have a legacy to leave my kids, or I really want to concentrate on getting out of debt, that they're going to have those resources to send me. But also, now that I've expressed my concerns, you said the next step is to talk to you, most likely. What does that look like? Do we talk right then, or do we set up a meeting? What does that look like?
Well, that's a great question. You know, just depending on my schedule, I always try to be available to answer the phone as much as I possibly can. I'm always going to take the few minutes to be able to talk to that person right then and there, just kind of find out what concern they might have, because realistically it could be an urgent situation. They could be dealing with something with a health claim or a possible death in the family or some type of an urgent planning strategy, and they need some help right now. And if they can't get their answer, they're going to try to dial through numbers and try to find somebody who can give them some answers. So I'm going to kind of try to ascertain right away, hey, listen, is this something we need to create an urgent type situation? And if not, then I want to keep it comfortable and easy with people. I think it's all about getting to know people. It's about getting to know them, what their worries, concerns are, and more importantly, if not as importantly, is them getting to know me. Who is on the other line? Who are they talking to? Who are they getting ready to ask some of these questions to? So it's important. Mm-hmm. So from that point, maybe we'll schedule a 15-minute telephone call. Something easy, something simple, 15-minute phone call. Or maybe we'll even do a Zoom call. I mean, some people would rather see face-to-face and maybe do a 15-20-minute, Zoom call. Or, again, if the situation is in a situation where we want to get together fairly quickly because of what they want to learn, well, then maybe we'll schedule a physical appointment. And that could be a half-hour, hour physical appointment, just depending on kind of what the need is. But I think finding out a little bit more about them, helping them understand a little bit more about us and how we can help them is probably the first step.
Yeah. So what should I be planning to bring to that meeting?
Well, again, that'll kind of probably depend on what we're trying to do and what you're kind of looking for. Again, usually I don't want people to bring a whole bunch of anything. Just bring themselves. Just come to me. Tell me what your ideas, what you're thinking about, what your worries are, what your concerns are, and what you're looking to be educated on. I know a whole variety of things people getting close to retirement need to be educated on, but you ever think about drinking out of a fire hose? It's kind of tough, right? We can't shower them with all this junk, right? It's about a bits and a pieces, a little bit at a time. So whatever most important to them is kind of the key. And if there are some urgent things, then we'll give them a list of a few things to kind of bring along just to help move the meeting along. But usually always we're getting together a second time having another conversation a second time. And then I'll say, okay, well, bring this stuff with you next time if you want to discuss it.
Yeah,
so keep it simple.
Really
keep
like
it
that.
Easy.
Yeah, I really like that because it gives me an opportunity to see if it's a right fit, but it also gives you an opportunity to see if it's a right fit. So I think that makes it very, very comfortable. I like that.
Yeah.
We've had this meeting, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, Zoom. I would suggest Zoom to the listening audience. Scott's a fantastic looking guy. So get him on Zoom.
And ba-dum-bum.
There you go. But really just... So we dive in a little bit more about me. I say, you know what, Scott, I really like what you bring to the table. I love the fact that you're giving me some free educational material, so on and so forth. I'd like to move forward now. And so what does that look like? What does that process look like for you? I know that obviously you're going to assign me some homework, a little bit of homework as far as documents or things that I need to bring to you so you have all the information you need. What's that next step?
Basically, our process is kind of simple. It's really a kind of a discovery, design, deploy type concept. That first meeting, we get through some just initial discovery, finding a little bit about them, a little bit about me. And then when we get together more of a serious scenario, now we're really going to put together, okay, what are your goals, dreams, desires? What are you looking to accomplish, and when are we looking to accomplish it? You know, it's kind of interesting. Sometimes people look at retirement as an ending. I'm leaving my job. I'm going to retire. It just sounds dismal, right? Mm-hmm. Well, I tell people, listen, retirement retirement should be your next great adventure. It's your retirement adventure, right? You work your whole life to save money and pay off your debts, to retire, to go out and do things, enjoy life, spend time with those grandkids, travel, right? Mm. But you need a plan of action to be able to do that. So in a lot of cases, like I mentioned in the first podcast, you asked me what does our typical client look like? And that's kind of a hard answer because there's times that we get referred somebody who just needs help with a drug plan. Maybe they're close to Medicaid and they just need help with understanding that. And that's all we help them with because that's all they need. And other people come in and they want to put together a whole complete plan to really design that great adventure, which is retirement. So really it'll depend on what the person is looking to accomplish at that meeting.
And I know that through our previous conversations on and off air, you've talked about your holistic approach to planning. For those that are listening, I know that the next podcast that Scott does is going to be all about their holistic approach to planning. So you don't want to miss that. I think that's fantastic. And just the private conversations that he and I have had, you're going to get a glimpse of those in future podcasts for sure. Just a wealth of information. So I'm looking forward to that. All right. Now, I've got my documents. You've taken a look, and let's just say, I would think the typical American, they want to make sure they have enough money to retire, and they're going to have enough money to last for their entire retirement. Nobody wants to try to have to go back to work at 93 years old. At least I don't think I will. So how does that look when it comes to you putting together a plan, looking at all of the pieces, like you said, holistically, putting all those pieces in place? How long does that take?
Well, usually that's a process of probably over 3 to 4 to 5 meetings, right? And it could be small, short meetings. And again, we're going to move along just as fast as we need to. But I think really getting to know the person that's coming to us is crucial. And again, getting them to know me. That's kind of funny. Sometimes people rush that process. And I mean advisors and planners kind of rush that process. And they just don't get all the facts. They don't get all the facts. And it's important to get all the facts, right? You know, that kind of reminds me of this cute little joke, right? This teacher goes up to Johnny and say, Johnny, listen, if I gave you two cats, and I gave you another two cats, and I gave you another two cats, how many cats you have? Well, Johnny says 7. And the teacher says, no, listen carefully. If I gave you two cats, and I gave you two cats, and another two cats, how many cats you have? Well, Johnny says 7. Teacher goes, no, let me put it a completely different way. You're not paying attention. If I gave you two apples, and two apples, and two apples, how many apples you have? Well, Johnny says 6. Teacher says, okay, good, you're getting it now. So again, if I gave you two cats, and two cats, and another two cats, how many cats you have? Well, Johnny says 7. The teacher says, Johnny, how the heck are you coming up with 7? Well, Johnny says, listen, I've already got a stinking cat, right?
Yeah.
So the point is, I got to find out what's truly important to this customer, what their situation is, and then kind of help design a plan around that. And some people have a lot of their ducks in a row, and they just need some tweaking and some adjusting. And some people don't have their ducks in a row at all, and that's going to take more of a complicated focus and a plan. So it could be 3, 4, 5, 6 meetings. My point is, I'm going to do is whatever I take, whatever it takes, and as long as it takes to really help the client feel comfortable and put them on a plan of action.
That is awesome. And that's a great story.
For those cat lovers out there, I didn't mean to say stinking cat. I love cats too, but I'm more of a dog liker. Nothing wrong with cats.
Yeah, no, we don't want to alienate half the audience.
Cat.
Yeah, exactly.
listen. Right?
That's right. Oh, man. So that's fantastic. I mean, that's such a great example of just somebody not taking the time to truly get to know the person on the other end of the phone or across the desk from them. And that happens too often. You see that in a lot of sales because they just want to rush through something to get that sale. And that's not what it's about. It's about the client sitting in front of you.
It really is, Eric. And it's crazily, when I talk to other friends of mine that actually do planning and stuff, they're just amazed by the numbers I give them of the referrals I get from people. They're just amazed. I mean, everybody gets referrals if you're good, but we get a tremendous amount of referrals. Yeah. And I think it really is because of our process. I mean, there's some people that come in that we talk through, we educate, we did never do business with, but we're always there for them if they need us. And we get referrals all the time of people we just never did business with because they think, listen, this is the guy, call this guy. You want an answer, call this guy. But they just didn't need to do any business with us at that point, but they refer us to people. So that's a great sign that we can really help people. And that's kind of the key.
Yeah, that's fantastic. Now, I know that you spoke about the team that you work with on the last podcast, so people can go back and listen to that. But one of the things that I know that you do is you have these ongoing and committed relationships with your clients. So once I'm a client, we've got this plan, you've helped me to implement it. How often do we meet after that? Because life changes, curveballs get thrown, so on and so forth.
Yeah. Putting together that plan, and that's just maybe a plan for your healthcare or a whole complete plan. Not only does we have to put that plan in place and deploy that plan, because action is the key, right? Nothing happens unless things are in motion. But the key is a great plan needs adjusted and tweaked as time goes on, because things will adjust and things will change. We really are committed to contacting our customers and being in a good communication with those folks. A lot of times with certain planners, it's like one and done. I seen you once, you're done, but I'll never see you again. I won't, you know, don't call me, I won't call you, everything's great. Well, no, I want to have a long-term relationship with people and help them through these changes and these adjustments, because then the plan's going to come to fruition if we make those adjustments to that situation. So it's important. That communication is the key.
Yeah. And I got a quick story about this, because one of my buddies entered the advisor role, more like just selling life insurance, really. And I was young, young family, and I wanted to help him out. He wanted to meet with me with his mentor, I guess. There's a company that will not be named because we don't want to talk about that company for sure. But he was new in the business. And so, yes, we absolutely signed up because we did not have any life insurance at that point. Signed up for a decent term policy that was fit our life at 23 years old. And then he stopped doing that business 6 months in. It didn't work out for him. So our account was handed to somebody else. It was a 10-year term. Scott, do you know how many times I heard from that new advisor in 9.5 years?
You're still waiting for a call, buddy. You're still waiting for the call.
No. I got the call. I did.
Good,
I got the
really?
Call.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes. 2 weeks before the policy was going to end. And super friendly, because he wanted to sell me something new. Never talked to me before in his life. Didn't know anything about my life. Didn't know any of the changes that had happened. If I had any more kids, if I got a windfall somehow, if I was alive or not. I mean, nothing. But sure enough, 2 weeks before it was going to expire, he's like, hey, buddy.
Yeah, like, yeah. Hey, buddy.
Nice try.
Yeah. And that's why we kind of developed that holistic planning. I know next podcast, we're going to get into details of our process, but finding out and doing that ongoing process is just so crucial. So many people out there, so many planners, they do one little thing and that's it. They don't find out about nothing else. But all that stuff kind of interacts with everything, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That happens all the time, sadly.
Yeah. And I know that you don't have the time to call people once a week. And I don't think anybody wants to get a phone call from their advisor once a week to check in. But as a client, when should I be reaching out to you to tell you that something has changed in my life? Because if you're meeting every 6 months or every year to review plans, what happens if something happens in between, like a very good thing or possibly a bad thing? When do you want your clients reaching out to you?
We want clients calling us anytime they need to. So if something changes, something adjusts, they have a question, I want them contacting us. And they're going to hear from us on a regular basis anyways. We send out quarterly mailers talking about this, that, and the other, and maybe new changes coming up. So we want to keep in communication, but we want that client reaching out. And there's clients we get together. If we're doing Medicare or drug plans, things like that, we're getting together once a year for sure. But usually with a lot of clients, we get together quarterly or maybe every 6 months. It just depends on the needs and what's going on in that client's life. But that open-ended communication is crucial. And I want the client picking up the phone and calling me if they got a question about their washer and dryer. Yeah, I can't help them with that washer and dryer, but that's kind of funny I say that, because a couple days ago, we had a client that's been with me for like 17 years. She's been with me forever. She was going to the store to buy a new washer and dryer. She was asking me which one she should buy. I'm like, Martha, I don't know nothing about washers and dryers, but you know, I have a Maytag and I love it. So there you go.
There you go, yeah.
But it's okay. Call us. We want to be there for you. We want to be the support system for you.
So give me some examples of life events that you would want your clients to tell you about and not hesitate, just because it could affect the plan that you guys have already put in place.
Of course, the basic ones, of course, you know, the death of a spouse, something like that happens, a bigger illness, not necessarily death, prescription drug changes. Sometimes people get put on a very expensive medication, and sometimes people are spending $300-$500 a month in a copay for a medication. I mean, that's a budgetable item when you get to copays like that, right?
Yeah.
So there might be some ways we can tweak their system. We might be able to find them some type of a pharmaceutical program that can kind of help them. So we want them to reach out, any type of a health need or what have you. And also family issues. There's times maybe one of their children, maybe their brother or sister are going through some issues. That person doesn't have to have insurance with us or coverage with us or have done any business with us. If they need somebody to call, we often tell our clients, listen, I don't want your son, I don't want your brother flipping through the yellow pages looking for somebody who can give them an answer. Mm-hmm. Have them call us. We would love to be able to. And if we don't know the answer, we'll help them find the answer or direct them to the answer. You know, that's kind of the key.
Yeah. Well, I'll tell you, I would assume that as my advisor, you'd want me to tell you about a birth of a grandchild, because that absolutely My wife went insane when that happened. We had a better retirement planned, but then she started shopping for the grandchildren and that shot everything to right in the boat. Yeah. Anyway, so speaking of boat, I'm not getting one. Yeah.
Truck keeps pulling up constantly. The truck that starts with an A and ends with a Zon.
Yeah, right? Exactly. Those
things, every 15 minutes, that's coming around the corner. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Sure, that's absolutely right.
Yeah, those life events are crucial. And sometimes it's good, bad, and the ugly, right? We want to hear about the good stuff. Absolutely. But, you know, sometimes it's the stuff that's not so fun, but maybe there's some things they need to tweak and adjust because of that. So it's crucial.
Fantastic. This has been a great glimpse of what it looks like to start the conversation with you. Are there any questions I should have asked you that I didn't?
I don't think so. But I tell you what, I said how incredibly blessed I am with my staff. I tell you, there is not a week that doesn't go by that I don't have somebody giving me a compliment on my staff.
Nice.
I mean, again, if you listen, I challenge you. If you think I'm making this up, salespeople make stuff. If you think I'm making this up, call my office and just talk to one of the people that answer the phone. Just talk to one of them. And you're going to be amazed the wonderful warm feeling you have just by talking to people. So again, that's no ploy. You don't believe me? Call the office and try to order pizza and just listen to one of my intake people. Just listen to one of them and I'll talk to you. They'll probably look up a telephone number for you.
Yeah.
Now if they're ordering pizzas for you, well. We might be pushing the envelope there, but I tell you what, I challenge you to call the office and just ask what we do, or ask our website, and just see the interaction you get.
Yeah, fantastic. Well, they can't do that without the phone number. So how do they call in?
Our website's duckduckplan.com. Please visit that. Check us out a little bit. A couple little short videos on that, and then of course you can reach us at 937-898-2273. That's 2273 CARE. So it's 898. CARE. And of course we have a toll-free number in today's society. Everybody's got free long distance, so it probably doesn't matter much. 937-898-CARE 2273.
Makes it easy. Scott, man, thank you so much. This is a great show today.
Listen, I had a great time. It was great talking to you again. Look forward to the next podcast.
Yeah, that next podcast all about your holistic approach to planning. So audience, please tune into that. Scott, again, thank you so much for your time. This is fantastic. And our last thank you goes to you, listening audience. Thank you for tuning in and listening to The Scotty Show with Scott Leonardi. If you have not subscribed to the podcast yet, please click the subscribe now button below. This way, when Scott comes out with a new podcast, it'll show up directly on your listening device. This makes it much easier to share these podcasts with your friends and family. And I'm going to encourage you to do that, especially this one, because if people are hesitant to reach out to an advisor because they think they're going to get sold something, like Scott mentioned earlier, it's not going to happen here. Share this podcast with them. Let them understand what it looks like to call in and who they're going to reach, the passion that this guy has for working with all the families that he does. They'll thank you for it. And again, thank you for listening today. For everyone at Complete Solutions, this is Eric Johnson reminding you, it's time to get your ducks in a row.
Thank you for listening to The Scotty Show. Remember, today is the first day of the rest of your life. Live life like it's your job. Click the subscribe button below to be notified when new episodes become available. The information covered and posted represents the views and opinions of the guest and does not necessarily represent the views or opinions of Complete Solutions, Inc. The content has been made available for informational and educational purposes only. The content is not intended to be a substitute for professional investing advice, tax advice, or legal advice. Always seek the advice of your financial advisor or other qualified financial service provider with any questions you may have regarding your investment planning.